Welcome to biology class. In this video we are going to start the topic invertebrata. Invertebrates are animals which do not have a backbone. We are going to cover the first three invertebrate phyla in this video. Let us start with the phylum Porifera. Pori means pore or openings. Fera means bear or having. These animals have small holes on the body. They are commonly called as sponges. They are pore bearing animals, commonly called as sponges. They are multicellular. These organisms are made up of many cells. They do not move from one place to another place. They are attached. They are aquatic. They live in water. Sponges are multicellular, non-motile aquatic organisms. What is meant by non-motile? Non-motile organisms do not move from one place to another place. The sponges have a water transport system. Water enters inside the body through small openings called as ostia. The body has minute pore called ostia. Through the ostia, water enters inside the body and water is transported through the transport system. The transport system through which the water flows is called as canal system. Canal system is found in sponges. In this system, through ostia are openings, through ostia water moves inside the body and flows. This is Venus flower basket, a kind of sponge. Another one is cycon. Sponges have canal system. Water enters inside and flows through the system. The moving water carries the food material, and when water flows inside the body, the organism gets oxygen. The water flows through the canal system. It carries food and oxygen. Now let us move on to the phylum Coelenterata. Coelenterata is the old name. The new name for the phylum is Cnidaria. What we see here is sea anemone. The animals live in water. They are multicellular. All are aquatic organisms. Most of the organisms are marine, and a few organisms live in fresh water. They are multicellular organisms. They have tissue grade of organization. They have radial symmetry. What is radial symmetry? In radial symmetry, the body can be divided into two equal parts from top to bottom through any number of lines. That is radial symmetry. The animals have tissue grade of organization. They have muscular tissue, epithelial tissues. This is jellyfish. It also belongs to the phylum Coelenterata. Animals of Coelenterata have two layers in the body wall, so they are diploblastic animals. The two layers in the body wall are outer ectoderm and inner endoderm. In between endoderm and ectoderm, these organisms have mesoglia. Mesoglia is not made up of cells, so it is not considered as a layer. At the center of the animals, there is a cavity called as gastrovascular cavity. Gastro, the word gastro refers to digestive system. Vascular means tubular. A tube-like cavity found at the center of the animals functions as the digestive system. So the cavity is gastrovascular cavity. It is also called as coelenteron. Enteron means digestive system. Coelo means cavity. This diagram shows the two layers in the body wall of coelenterates. This is outer ectoderm. This is inner endoderm. In between these two, there is mesoglia. Mesoglia is not made up of cells. This is sea anemone. Animals belong to the phylum Coelenterata have a mouth at the center. Around the mouth, finger-like structures are seen. They are called as tentacles. Mouth of coelenterates are surrounded by tentacles. These tentacles have stinging cells. Honey bee has stings. Here, the animals have stinging cells. The stinging cells have poison. The stinging cells are useful to capture the food organism, and the animals use the stinging cells to escape from the enemies. These stinging cells are called as nematocysts. Hydra and jellyfish are the examples for the phylum Coelenterata. This is jellyfish. This is Hydra. Hydra is cylindrical animal. Jellyfish is umbrella-like animal. In this phylum, the animals have two functional forms, that is called as polymorphism. Umbrella-like form and cylindrical form. These two functional forms are called as polymorphism. Now let us move on to the phylum Platyhelminthes. Platy means flat, helminth means worms. These animals are called as flatworms. Their body is flat. This is liver fluke. It lives inside the body of sheep. It is flattened like a small leaf. These organisms are bilaterally symmetrical. The body can be divided into two equal halves through one line. They are triploblastic animals. They have ectoderm, endoderm, and mesoderm. They are acoelomates because they do not have the body cavity. This is tapeworm. Animals belong to the phylum Platyhelminthes have suckers and hooks for attachment. These animals are parasites. What are parasites? Parasites are organisms which live on another organism. These parasites use the suckers and hooks for the purpose of attachment. This is anterior end of tapeworm. This tapeworm anterior end shows hooks and suckers. Hooks and suckers are the organs of attachment. Suckers and hooks help the animal to attach itself to the body of the host. Human being is the host for the tapeworm. Tapeworm is the parasite. Flatworms have flame cells. Flame cells are special cells. they remove waste material from the body. This is the diagram of flame cell. Flame cells remove the waste materials from the body. The process of removing waste materials from the body is called as excretion. In our body, kidneys perform the function of excretion. In platycal minthus organisms, excretion is done by flame cells. They are hermaprodites. Hermaprodites animals have both male and female organs in the same animal. Liver fluke and tapeworm are the common examples for the phylum Platyhelminthes. In the next video, we will discuss about the remaining phyla of invertebrates.